Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn something really very important, that's Gordon's growth model. It is used for valuation purpose, for finding the market price per share, and a really renowned and a very popular model. The Gordon's growth model is also basically known as the dividend discount model. That is used to basically evaluate the intrinsic value, that is the price of the share of the stock exclusively by discounting the future dividend payments by the company. So as per the Gordon's growth formula, the intrinsic value of the stock is equal to the sum of all the present value of the future dividends. We note from this particular graph exactly that companies like McDonald's and there are companies like Kimberly Clark, Procter & Gamble, PepsiCo, 3M, Coca-Cola, Johnson & Johnson, they pay regular dividends, and we can use Gordon growth model to value such companies. So what exactly is the formula? What exactly this is all about? See, there are two basic types of model. One is called the stable model and another is called the multi-stage model. Okay, that is the multi-stage model. The stable model assumes that the dividend growth is constant over time. However, the multi-stage growth model does not assume constant growth over dividend. Hence, we have to evaluate each year's dividend separately. However, eventually the multi-stage model assumes a constant dividend growth. So let's now see how the Gordon's growth formula, an example for each type of the model and calculation of the stock price. Let's understand that. We'll talk about the stable growth model. Using the stable growth model, we can get something like this. P0, that is your price, which we are trying to find, which is also known as the value of the stock, which is equal to your D1, that is your dividend in D0 into 1 plus growth, that is dividend in the current year, plus the growth rate when you apply, so dividend for the future years, and divide by K minus G. Your K over here is the cost of capital and G over here is your growth rate. So D1 over here, it's the next year's expected annual dividend per share. K is the discount rate or the required rate of the return estimated using the capital asset pricing model. And G is the expected dividend growth rate assumed to be at the constant. So the other assumptions of the Gordon's growth formula is that, you know, we assume that company grows at constant growth, the company has stable financial leverage, the life of the firm is indefinite, and the required rate of return remains constant. So let's understand an example on stable growth model, Gordon's growth model example. Let's assume that there is a company ABC, and it will pay a dividend of, let's say, $5. The dividend of the next year, which is expected to grow, will be 3% every year. And further, the required rate of return, that is the WACC, let's say, is 8%. That is basically K. So what is the intrinsic value of the company ABC? Right. So in this scenario, it's really very easy. The next year's dividend is going to be how much? That is, over here we are trying to find D1. D1 is going to be $5, as we know from the above. The rate of the return to the investor is, that is rate of return 8%, as it's quite visible to us. The growth rate, that is our G, is 3%, right? So the value of the stock using the Gordon's growth model, that is our P0, is going to be D1 divided by R minus G. So 5 divided by 8 minus 3, that is 5%, which will give us answer as simple as that, 100. So we have assumed a constant growth rate over here, which is 3%. And this could be true for stable companies. However, the dividend growth could vary for growing and declining companies. Hence, we use multi-stage model, and thus using the stable model, the value of the stock is 100 now. If the stock is trading at, let's say, 70, then it will be undervalued. And if the stock is, let's say, trading at 120, then it is said to be overvalued. If you see over here, I've shown you a graph over here, Walmart. Let's look at this Walmart's dividend paid in the last 30 years. Okay, since 1995 to 2015, Walmart is a mature company. And we note, you know, that the dividend have steadily increased over the period. This means that we can value Walmart Gordon's growth model calculation. Now we'll discuss the next thing, that is the multi-stage growth model. And let's take a Gordon's growth multi-stage model of a company wherein we have a couple of things with us, and then we can start with the example. Let's say we have some details as current dividend, that is D0, is let's say $12. We have growth as 20%. Then we have growth in dividend for, this is growth in dividend for 4 years, and for the next 4 years is going to be let's say 8%. So dividend for the next 4 years is let's say 8%, and let's say the cost of equity is let's say 15%. So in all the scenario, find the value of the firm using the Gordon's growth model calculation. Let's understand this. Now, first and the foremost thing is the calculation of dividend for each year till the stable growth rate is reached. So we calculate the high growth rate dividends until 2020. As you can see, the dividend is 12, okay? And then you add the growth rate of 20%, okay, on this. And then it goes on for 4 years. 20%, 20%, 20%, 20% for 4 years. Okay, in this fashion you get dividend till 2020. From 12, it started from 12 and reached to 24.9. The next stage is calculate the Gordon's growth model terminal value, which is the end value of the high growth phase. Okay, we use over here the Gordon's growth, again Gordon's growth model, and we can calculate the growth model the terminal value in 2020. It's really very simple. It's nothing rocket science over here. The last dividend, 26.9, okay, that will be divided by the what you can say K minus G, and we'll get the final value as the Gordon's terminal value as 383.9. The step three is the calculate the present value of all the projected dividends. So present value of all of this, the present value of dividends during the high growth phase from 2017 to 2020, which is given below. We have the terminal value, and the present value of the cash flow over here has been done, and the sum is done. Finally, we for present, for discounting, we have the expected return of 15%, which we are using it, which is the WACC of the company. Then find the present value of the Gordon's growth model terminal value. So the terminal value which you found, you will have to discount that, and you have to bring it back to the present, and you will have the present value of the terminal value. So present value of cash flows, all the details you have, present value of the terminal value you have, and the final thing, it will be sum it up. So find the fair value, the present value of the projected dividends, and the present value of the terminal value. So as we already know that the intrinsic value of the stock is the present value of the future cash flow, and since we have calculated the present value of dividend and the present value of the terminal value, we can just sum this both the things up, okay? That will be the intrinsic value or the fair value of the company, right? After discussing the two different models that we were supposed to do, the stable and the multi-stage model, multi-stage model, we can finally conclude on this above. Gordon's growth model also is really very simple to understand. Is based on number of critical assumptions. This has its own limitation. However, this model can be based or used for stable companies having a history of dividend payments and a future growth. So for more unpredictable companies, the multi-stage model could be used by taking into account some more realistic assumptions. Thank you, everyone.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.